नमस्कार चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द चैप्टर कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम। रिसोर्सेज, एनीथिंग विच इज यूजफुल फॉर ह्यूमन बीइंग इज नोन एज रिसोर्स। नाउ रिसोर्सेज कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू टू टाइप्स, नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज एंड मैनमेड resources. Natural resources we obtain from nature and man-made resources are made by human beings. Natural resources can again be divided into two types, exhaustible natural resources and inexhaustible natural resources. Exhaustible natural resources are present in limited quantity, and if we will not use them wisely, then they will exhaust and they will not be available for future use. For example, all the fossil fuels are exhaustible natural resource, which we will study in this chapter. Inexhaustible natural resources are present in unlimited quantity in nature. For example, air, sunlight, and they will not be exhausted if we will use them continuously. Now, fossil fuels. Fossil fuels are fuels that are formed by fossils, which are dead remains of living organisms. Coal, petroleum, natural gas, all these are fossil fuels, and these are exhaustible natural resources. Means if we will not use them wisely, then they will be exhausted and not be available for future use. Coal is a black colored fossil fuel which is extracted from the ground and is used as a fuel for different purposes. Coal mainly consists of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, and some small amount of sulfur is also present in coal. Coal was formed when huge forest areas got buried under the surface of earth. Under hot and humid conditions, they were attacked by anaerobic bacteria, which removed hydrogen and oxygen, leaving behind carbon. So due to very high temperature and pressure of the earth, the carbon got compact to form stony residues, which are known as coal. So the slow conversion of wood into coal by a biochemical process extending over millions of years is called carbonization. There are mainly four varieties of coal: peat, lignite, bituminous and anthracite. Peat is youngest variety of coal and anthracite is oldest variety of coal. So peat is having lowest carbon content, that is 50 to 60%, and anthracite is having highest carbon content, which is 90 to 95%. Now, destructive distillation of coal. The process of heating any substance in absence of air is known as destructive distillation. And the process of heating coal in the absence of air is called destructive distillation of coal. Coal contains a number of elements like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and sulfur. Now when this coal is heated in absence of air strongly, then number of products are obtained which have commercial value. So some of these products are like coke, coal gas, ammonium liquor and coal tar. Coke is grayish black, hard porous solid. Some of the uses of coke are that it is used as a fuel, it is used in manufacture of steel and some other materials, it is also used in some chemical reactions because it acts as a reducing agent. Coal tar. Coal tar is a highly viscous liquid and it has an extremely unpleasant smell. There are different uses of coal tar. So this coal tar is used in manufacture of paints, perfumes, synthetic dyes, photographic material, drugs and explosives. It can also be used to make insecticides and pesticides. Naphthalene balls are also made from coal tar. Now, different products are obtained by fractional distillation of coal tar. So, when this coal tar is subjected to fractional distillation, we obtain various products like benzene, naphthalene, toluene, anthracene, phenol, and the residue which is left after this fractional distillation is pitch. Coal gas is also one of the product obtained from destructive distillation of coal. Its smell is not very pleasant, and why? Because it contains some sulfur compounds. So it is a highly flammable gas, and the main component of this is methane. It is also used as a fuel in industries. Earlier it was used as a source of light. Petroleum. Petroleum is a dark colored, thick crude oil found deep below the ground in certain areas. The name petroleum means rock oil because we obtain these petroleum under the rocks. It is called petroleum because it is found under the crust of earth trapped in rocks. Petroleum is a mixture of various hydrocarbons, which are mainly made up of carbon and hydrogen. Now, how formation of petroleum takes place? The microscopic plants and animals died under the sea, and then later on they covered by sand and mud and decomposed in the absence of air under high pressure and temperature. So, by this process, petroleum and natural gas are formed. So, generally, along with petroleum, natural gas is also found. Oil refining or fractional distillation. Now, oil refining or fractional distillation is the process of separating various liquids which are present in this petroleum with different boiling points at different temperature using fractional columns. So, various products are collected at different temperature in fractionating column. Refining of petroleum gives various products. Petroleum is a mixture of various constituents such as petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, etc. So, these are some uses of the various products like LPG. LPG is used as a fuel for home and industry. Petrol is used as a fuel for automobiles and as a solvent for dry cleaning. Kerosene. Kerosene is used as a fuel for stoves, lamps, etc. And in very purified form, it is also used as an aviation fuel. Diesel is used as a fuel for heavy motor vehicles, generators, lubricating oil for lubrication. Paraffin wax is used in ointments, in vaselines, in candles. Bitumen is used for making paints and for surfacing roads. Now, natural gas is also one of the fossil fuels. It is a very important fuel and is easy to transport through pipes. It can be compressed and stored under high pressure as compressed natural gas or CNG. It is considered as a clean fuel because it do not cause any pollution, and also it has high calorific value. Now, various uses of natural gas, like natural gas is used as a fuel because it has a high calorific value of approximately 55 kilojoule per gram. It is also used as a source of hydrogen and carbon, as we can see in this reaction. Now, conservation of fossil fuels. Conservation of fossil fuel is very important because it took millions of years for formation of these fossil fuels like coal, petroleum and natural gas, and their reserves are limited. So if we do not use them judiciously or wisely, then they will not be available for our future generations. Also, fossil fuels are responsible for air pollution. Mainly carbon dioxide gas is released from these fossil fuels, and carbon dioxide is responsible for global warming. Some other gases are also released which are responsible for acid rain, or like carbon monoxide, which is responsible for respiratory problems. Now, some preventive measures to save fuels by PCRA or Petroleum Conservation Research Association. We should drive vehicles at average and constant speed. When not necessary, shut down the vehicle's engine, like on red lights. Make sure pressure in tires is correct and always keep vehicles under good condition.
Thanks for watching.